In this series, we're going to look at the key concepts that you'll need in order to deploy device service clustering for high availability. In this video, we'll focus on introducing the basics of device service clustering. Device service clustering, or DSC, is a high availability solution for ensuring that your big IP devices are always available to process application traffic. When you put two or more big IP devices in a cluster or device group, they can reliably work together to process requests and responses from multiple applications. In the simplest configuration, all devices in the group are identical hardware or virtual platforms, although this is not a requirement. In fact, the only requirements for devices to be eligible for inclusion in the same device group are that they are licensed identically, running the same version of Big IP software, and have the same Big IP modules provisioned. The most common type of device group is a sync-failover device group, where all devices can regularly use a process called configuration synchronization, or config sync, to sync their Big IP configurations to one another. Successful failover depends on all Big IP configurations matching in a device group at all times. If a device processing in application flow becomes unavailable for any reason, failover occurs and another device can take over to process that flow. A device that's processing in application flow can mirror its connections to another device in the device group to minimize disruption to the connection on failover. It's also important to note that you put up to 8 devices in a sync failover device group, and each device can be actively processing one or more application flows. Here's a flowchart that shows the sequence of steps required to implement DSC. First, on each device, you must tell the Big IP system which self-IP addresses that the other devices should use to sync their configurations, communicate about failover, and mirror their connections. Next, you must have the devices exchange their device certificates to ensure that they trust one another. This is a prerequisite to all other DSC operations. Third, you must create a sync failover device group containing up to 8 devices. Next, from one device, you sync its configurations to the other devices. If you plan on a device group handling multiple application flows, you might want to create additional floating traffic groups beyond the default one. And if you want a device to mirror its connections to another device, you can enable connection mirroring on the relevant virtual server. Finally, you must sync the configuration again. To recap, there are a few key points to remember about DSC. DSC ensures that all Big IP devices in a device group have the same Big IP configurations at all times. The most common type of device group is a sync failover device group. A sync failover device group synchronizes the Big IP configuration on all devices, provides failover capability, and can mirror connections from one device to another. And you can put up to 8 devices into a sync failover device group. Thank you for watching, and be sure to check out part 2.